Hello everyone, it's Stacy here. In this video, I will show you how to decorate your pages with icons using Getwit. With the help of the icon block, you can create plain but intuitive interfaces, visualize information, and create catchy lists. Subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with our WordPress tutorials. As always, before you start, make sure that you have the latest version of Getwit installed on your website. It can be installed through the Plugins tab, Add New, search for Getwit, Install, and Activate. To add an icon, open the page where you want it to appear, click Plus, and select the icon block from the Getwit section. This block has inline settings if you want to align the icon. This icon block comes with Font Awesome pre-installed, which means that you have access to hundreds of high-quality icons. Find a suitable icon by typing its name in the search field or select one by browsing categories. You may display a plain icon, an icon with a background, or an icon with an outline. Whichever you choose, it is possible to change the color of the icon itself and the background to anything you want. The icon size can be specified in pixels, ms, percentages, viewport height, and viewport width. M is the size relative to the current font size, and viewport height and width are specified in percentages and mean a size relative to the current screen. Space around icon is the space between the icon and its border in pixels. Border radius defines how rounded the corners of your icon should be. You can also make the icon link to a different page or a place on the current page by specifying a link in the next field. Link rel is a link relationship between the current page and the target one. You can leave it empty as it is by default or specify a relationship if you need a more advanced setting for your link. Note that once you toggle the link to always open in a new page, WordPress adds two relationships by default, no referrer and no opener. No referrer means that the owner of the target page will not know where a visitor is coming from if the visitor clicks this link. Their analytics will simply show it as direct traffic with no information about the source. This may be useful for SEO, and it is not recommended to have this tag if you are not linking to an external website. No opener means that the target page will have no control over this page, which adds an extra layer of security. With the next field, you can apply a hover animation to the icon, which will make the page more interactive. Margin is the space between the border of your icon and neighboring elements on the page. If you want to add custom styles to this icon, give it a custom CSS class in the Advanced section. The icon block can be transformed into the icon box block if you need a pre-made layout with an icon. It can also be added directly from your toolbox. The icon box block has essentially the same settings as the icon block. But here you can also select the layout and alignment of your content. If you select a horizontal layout, you can also choose the vertical alignment for your icon. This pre-made layout comes with an icon, a heading, and a paragraph block. But you can add any other block to it if needed. These are all the settings for the icon block. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or suggestions. Like the video if you liked it, and subscribe to our channel for more WordPress tutorials. Thank you for watching, and have a great one!